what's going on, strong friends from all different social media platforms right now. This might be podcast, YouTube video, or my website. I'm trying to wrap this all into one. So if you're watching on my social media feed, hello. If you're listening, what's going on? This is the updated version of episode 9 of the Courtney for Life podcast. I am talking about the plans and the different styles of nutrition that I offer with my coaching. So first, welcome to Courtney for Life. You're on my page and you're listening to this because you're interested in joining my thriving team of Quartz athletes, and I'm honestly so happy that you are here. So, like I said, I'm gonna explain the two differences of my nutrition-based approaches with my guidance. So there's flexible dieting and there's mindful portions. Now, on my website, you can see the breakdown of everything else that's included in my coaching services that I offer. This audio that you're listening to is just the two nutrition approaches. So if you're watching this, I am looking down at my screen. So if you see me looking down, that's why, just to make sure that I cover everything. So first up, we have flexible dieting. This is the most popular amongst my athletes, but it doesn't necessarily mean that it's the better approach for you. So flexible dieting consists of tracking your macronutrient intake, protein, carbohydrates, and fats. This program does involve weighing out your food and tracking it in a daily food log on your phone. So either My Macros Plus or MyFitnessPal, both are good options. The plan does require quite a serious level of commitment. It's not about guessing and just saying like, oh, it might be one cup of salad. Like, you have to be accurate with this. But I will be honest, it is intense. But by us being more precise on tracking these numbers, we're able to adjust better and create way better results that align with your goals. It's like the fine tuning that you probably couldn't get just from tracking calories or doing portion control. Second option is mindful portions. This program is really popular with clients that are a little older, maybe around 35 to 50 years old. It's not about tracking calories, but it's more so like a points-based system, similar to Weight Watchers, if you're familiar with that. But I've customized that, so it's way more individualized per client and therefore way more successful. Think about, if you're familiar with Weight Watchers, it's like Weight Watchers hybrided in with flexible dieting to create this like amazingness that is mindful portions. So what I do is I collect your food preferences, and then based off of what you're currently eating, I set up categories for food. So in each category, you have a certain number of points associated with portion sizes, like cups and tablespoons. So you don't need a food logging app for this, which makes it a lot more easier and a lot more sustainable for most, I'm gonna say, middle-aged people. Okay, and then you have a total number of points that I recommend you hit in each category each day. And these points, again, are based on your needs and goals. None of them push for food restrictions besides ones that personally cause you digestive issues or allergens. Both approaches I teach you how to continue to eat the foods you love while ensuring your body is as healthy as possible. And then we can shift your body composition to whatever your ideal goals are. I will be completely honest and say that I am not a registered dietitian, and my plans are not intended to treat or cure any eating disorders or health issues. I absolutely recommend, I will refer out if that is the case. Now, customized strength training programming is available for both of these nutrition approaches. I'm not getting into those right now. But I bet you're wondering what the timelines are for success for either of these approaches. So to be completely honest, no sustainable program is gonna give you drastic results in 2 weeks or even 2 months. My athletes are most successful when they commit to long-term health, and at absolute bare minimum, 4 months. The best success I have with my clients are with clients who don't set end dates with their goals, and they have been with me for at least 8 months. Those are the ones that I see the best success with. And obviously, the longer you stay with me, the more successful you are until you feel like you're ready to graduate. One of the biggest goals with new clients is that they want to lose weight and they want to be more toned. But in order for this to happen, we have to ensure that we have a healthy set point for the body and the metabolism, and we have to ensure we have enough muscle mass in order to reveal or give off that tone that many desire. So if a client has been following any kind of diet within the last 6 months, so probably in the form of restricting calories, then they usually need to start either hitting maintenance amount of calories, where they are no longer in a caloric deficit and not trying to technically lose weight, which will help them heal and improve their metabolism. So either hitting maintenance or reversing caloric intake, where we slowly increase calories over a period of time to allow the metabolism to adapt at a higher set point and overall body functions. This is not massing or bulking, I promise, trust me. If you, my wonderful future client, does not want to gain weight, then we're absolutely not going to be pushing for you to gain more weight. We do this very slowly and in a very, very healthy way. So either hitting maintenance calories or reversing calories for at least 4 months before we begin to cut. The way I see it, the longer you've been dieting, the longer we need to stay in this building phase. Then, once calories have been increased and the body's regular functions have been restored, then we can look at cutting calories and peeling away the fat mass. I like to make sure clients have at least 10 to 20 times their body weight in calories for a prolonged period of time before we even start to cut. And our bodies aren't super amazing at multitasking, which means if we want to lose body fat and increase calories, or at the very least not be in a caloric deficit when we're starving the body, at the same time, it's almost too much to ask. There are a few genetically blessed people who can do that, but for the general population of our clients who come to me, especially women who have gone through years of yo-yo dieting, it's just not gonna work. Sorry. So, if we're looking at specific timelines and numbers, if you've been trying to follow any type of diet or trying to lose weight at any point over the last 6 months, then I believe that there's at least 4 months, let's call it caloric rebuilding, that needs to happen. Cutting or dieting down can take anywhere from 4 weeks to 4 months, depending on the client's body and how well it responds based on lifestyle and caloric deficit. We can go through mini cuts like I've done with many clients, especially during the summer months. So looking at 4 months of slowly cutting back calories, and once the client hits a good weight loss goal, which is usually, again, depending on the client, anywhere from 2 to 10% of their fat mass, then we can slowly increase calories again, rebuilding that caloric intake in order to reverse in a very healthy way. Ultimately, we want to be dieting down or losing body fat while doing the least amount of cardio and eating the most amount of food, right? I think anyone can agree with me on that. So if you've been unsure about which style or timeline of nutrition guidance you want to commit with me, I hope this information does provide a little bit more insight. You can submit your client inquiry via my webpage when you're ready to let me guide you to success. Thanks for listening and watching. Have a strong day, friends.